Can we talk about, you know, you mentioned the possible case of stopping the intermittent hormone therapy and maybe doing it for a short time period versus a long time period. And I think that anytime somebody's on a treatment, what they really want is the cure. But since prostate cancer is a chronic disease and you kind of really have to monitor it, and there's different treatments that work for certain periods of times, a lot of times, not saying there aren't treatments that totally do kill it, there are, but how does a man who's on intermittent hormone therapy really know where he's at? Like, do you just monitor PSA, and if the PSA is rising up, you know, it's not a cure, he went into a short remission? Can you define what those terms are?
Yeah, I mean, the issue is primarily driven by PSA. The PSA is a unique marker for prostate cancer. We don't have really anywhere near as effective hormone treatments for other cancers like we have for prostate, and we don't have anywhere near as accurate markers as we have with PSA. So the whole idea in taking a holiday is that this amount of cancer in these gentlemen has been reduced to very tiny amounts, and that when the treatment is stopped and the testosterone comes back and the cancer starts growing again, if you allow the PSA to, say, rise up to 5 or 6 or something in that range, you really haven't given the cancer much of a head start. And then the typical policy then is to restart the treatment and, of course, not allow the cancer to get out of control. But that time period from the PSA going down, you know, starting at 0 and going up to 5 or 6, may be several years, and quality of life can certainly be improved during that time period. Another thing that's come up with intermittent treatment is with the advent of these new PSMA PET scans is we can now start looking for where the cancer is, and possibly when that is discovered, treat it with a spot radiation. And this is called the whole field of oligometastatic disease, which is a big topic we're not going to go into right now. But the idea of trying to cure some of these men that previously were incurable because we couldn't really locate where the cancer was.
I have a patient recently who asked PCRI if they can take testosterone replacement therapy when they're doing intermittent hormone therapy.
Yeah, well, that would be the exact situation where it could be discussed. So if someone has stopped his Lupron with the idea that they want to get their testosterone back, but that after a period of, say, 6 months, there's no evidence of normal testosterone production, we'll have a conversation about giving some testosterone. The testosterone that comes from the testicles or from a cream or a shot is all identical. So there's no real reason to be prejudiced against the guys who's got weak testicles. He can take some testosterone if it's appropriately supervised.
Can you talk a little bit about bone density and hormone therapy? And do they take a pause in the bone density drug when they're off hormone therapy? How does that work?
Well, people lose calcium quickly from their bones when their testosterone is low, just as postmenopausal women who lose their estrogen also lose calcium quickly. And then if that becomes extreme, we call that osteoporosis, which is the bones have become so weakened that they're at risk for fractures. That can be easily prevented with oral medications like Fosamax, Boniva, Actonel, or injectable medicines such as Prolia. And typically those things should be done routinely. You can check people's bone density with a simple scan to determine if people are predisposed to fractures, but almost everyone loses calcium from their bones when they're going through this treatment. So our typical policy is put people on medications automatically, regardless of how good the bone density is to start with, because we don't want it to get worse.
Can you actually speak to diet when it comes to hormone therapy and intermittent hormone therapy? I know that's a long, huge subject, but in regards to when it comes to, you know, their testosterone going low, obviously they're going to gain weight and you want to do muscle resistance. How much does diet affect that?
Diet's everything. It's just a matter of caloric intake. The problem is that if people lose muscle, their metabolism slows down. So if they just stay on the same diet that they've always eaten, they're going to start to accumulate weight. So people have to take special precautions and cut back, maybe drop one meal a day or something like that, and they won't gain weight. But if people stay in their normal mode of what they've always done and their metabolism is slowing down, they're going to put on some weight, usually around the middle.
Thank you so much for watching. If you would like more information, you can visit our website at pcri.org. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel. We come out with new prostate cancer videos every week.